We welcome you all to this video. We have seen an interesting example in the previous video based on the surface area of a cube and cuboid. Today, in this video, we will see some more interesting examples based on this.
What are you doing with this tarpaulin?
I have to make a cubic structure with the help of this tarpaulin. That structure does not need to have any front and base surfaces. This will serve as a house for my dog. But I do not understand how much tarpaulin will I need for this.
We can find the answer through mathematics. That means it's math time! Okay, tell me what will be the length of the sides of your cubical structure?
About 32 inches.
Assuming that the extra fabric of the tarpaulin used at the time of sewing will be negligible, the tarpaulin used in your cubic structure will need to have area of front face and base area subtracted from the total surface area of the cubic structure.
Yeah, good. The formula for the total surface area of a cube is 6 times the square of the measurement of the sides of the cube. Let me quickly find the total surface area of this cubic structure by putting 32 inches as the side of this cube.
Look, Thomas, by solving it in this way, we can see that the total surface area of your cubic structure is 6,144 square inches. Now, we just have to subtract the areas of the front and base area from it, and then we will get the size of your tarpaulin.
Both the front and base area are congruent. Therefore, their areas will be the square of the measurement of their sides. In this way, the sum of the areas of the two surfaces will be 2 times the square of the measure of the sides. The length of the sides of the structure is 32 inches. Let me solve it quickly by writing it here. Look, we got 4096 square inches of tarpaulin.
Yes, did you see how easy it is? Let us quickly return to our world. We also have to make the structure for your dog's house.
Both the friends together made a nice structure for Thomas's doghouse with tarpaulin. Friends, in this video, we saw another interesting example based on the surface area of cube and cuboid. So hopefully, by now you will have a good understanding of the surface area of cube and cuboid.